fever is the body's natural response to an infection. So it's your body's way of turning on the immune system. A lot of parents see the number and they get concerned. 101, 102, 103, and therefore they bring their kids in. And sometimes those visits are not necessary and they can handle a lot of that at home. If you think your kid has a fever, the most important thing to do is get a thermometer and check to see if they actually have one. And the number that you're looking for is 100.4 or higher. You don't necessarily have to give them fever medication such as acetaminophen or ibuprofen. You can first start by trying to cool them off naturally by taking off layers of clothing. If that doesn't work, a lukewarm bath. And then if your kid is uncomfortable, then you can decide whether you need to give them acetaminophen or ibuprofen. Acetaminophen is a medication that is dosed every 4 hours. Ibuprofen is a medication, it has a dosing for every 6 hours. Most of the anti-fever medications are based on your child's weight. On the back of the package, it tells you how to determine the dose. It takes about 30, 45 minutes for it to actually work. And a lot of parents see that their kid, they get more interactive. They want to take a drink. They want to walk around a little bit. And I tell parents that that's reassuring because that means without any antibiotics and without any intervention other than an anti-fever medication, your child had more energy, which is reassuring that it probably is a viral illness. If your kid is lethargic, if your kid's breathing fast, if your kid won't wake up to eat or drink, then that's more, you know, a more serious indication of how sick your kid is than the number of the fever. We have some children with a fever of 104 and they're running around the room playing. That's not a kid with a serious infection. If they're less than 2 months old, they have not received their first set of immunizations, and so their immune system is not strong enough to handle that type of infection. Therefore, they should come to the emergency department if they're less than 2 months with the fever. If you go to the doctor's office and the temperature is one number, like 101, and they diagnose you with a virus or an ear infection, and then you go home and it turns to 102 or 103 in the middle of the night, that does not necessarily mean you have to come to the emergency department, because a fever might actually last for 5 to 6 days with a regular viral infection. But the fever with the neck stiffness, you mean you can't move your neck, that's a problem. You know, fever with no wet diapers, that's a problem. Fever with persistent vomiting, that's a problem. If she's very irritable, severe headache, those are problems that we don't like to see. I always tell people to call their primary care doctor first, and with their primary care doctor's direction, then they can determine if they really need to come to the emergency department.